providing a record sum of 1,10,055 crores for railways, of which 1,07,100 crores is for capital expenditure only. Urban infrastructure. We will work towards raising the share of public transport in urban areas through expansion of metro rail networks and augmentation of city bus services. A new scheme will be launched at a cost of 18,000 crores to support augmentation of public bus transport services. The scheme will facilitate deployment of innovative PPP models to enable private sector players to finance, to acquire, to operate, and to maintain over 20,000 buses. The scheme will boost the automobile sector, provide fillip to economic growth, create employment opportunities for our youth, and enhance ease of mobility for urban residents. A total of 702 kilometers of conventional metro is operational, and another 1,016 kilometers of metro and RRTS is under construction in 27 cities. Two new technologies, that is Metro Lite and Metro Neo, will be deployed to provide metro rail systems at much lesser cost with same experience, convenience, and safety in Tier 2 cities and peripheral areas of Tier 1 cities also. Central counterpart funding will be provided to Kochi Metro Railway Phase 2 of 11.5 kilometer at a cost of 1,957.05 crores. Chennai Metro Railway Phase 2 of 118.9 kilometers at a cost of 63,246 crores. Bengaluru Metro Railway Project Phase 2A and 2B of 58.19 kilometers at a cost of 14,788 crores. Nagpur Metro Rail Project Phase 2 and Nashik Metro at a cost of 5,976 crores and 2,092 crores respectively. Power infrastructure. The past 6 years have seen a number of reforms and achievements in power sector. We have added 139 gigawatts of installed capacity, connected an additional 2.0 households, and added 1.41 lakh circuit kilometers of transmission lines. The distribution. Either government or private. There is a need to provide choice to the consumers by promoting competition. A framework will be put in place to give consumers alternatives to choose from among more than one distribution companies. I read that sentence again. A framework will be put in place to give consumers alternatives to choose from among more than one distribution company. The viability of distribution companies is a serious concern. A revamped, reforms-based, result-linked power distribution sector scheme will be launched with an outlay of 3,05,984 crores over 5 years. The scheme will provide assistance to DISCOMs for infrastructure creation, including prepaid smart metering, feeder separation, upgradation of systems, etc., tied to financial improvements. Prime Minister, while speaking at the third reinvestment conference in November 2020, had announced plans to launch a comprehensive national hydrogen energy mission. It is now proposed to launch a hydrogen energy mission in 2021-22 for generating hydrogen from green power sources. Ports, shipping and waterways. Major ports will be moving from managing their operational services on their own to a model where a private partner will manage it for them. For the purpose, seven projects worth more than 2,000 crores will be offered by the major ports on private-public partnership mode in FY21-22. A scheme for promoting flagging of merchant ships in India will be launched by providing subsidy support to Indian shipping companies in global tenders floated by ministries and CPSCs. An amount of 1,624 crores will be provided over 5 years. This initiative will enable greater training and employment opportunities for Indian seafarers, besides enhancing Indian companies' share in global shipping. India has enacted Recycling of Ships Act in 2019 and acceded to the Hong Kong International Convention. Around 90 ship recycling yards at Alang in Gujarat have already achieved HKC compliant certificates. Efforts will be made to bring more ships to India from Europe and Japan. Recycling capacities of around 4.5 million light displacement ton LDT will be doubled by 2024. This is expected to generate an additional 1.5 lakh jobs for our youth.